I'm going to show you how to use physics-based raycasting in order to select objects in your game. My name is Charles, and this is Infallible Code, a channel designed to help you become a better game developer. If you want to learn more about game programming, Unity, and game development, then be sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell icon so you'll be notified every single time a new tutorial is made available. I've created this very basic scene. It includes a simple environment, a UI, a couple of objects, and an FPS controller. Why don't we go ahead and press play? So we can see that there's a red dot at the center of the screen, and this is just a part of our UI. And it's going to signify which one of our objects is selected. So when the dot intersects with any one of these dark gray objects, we expect that this object will be selected or selectable. Now, typically, you'd want to allow the player to equip or use or pick up any of these objects, but to keep this tutorial simple, all we're going to do is just highlight these objects by replacing its default material with a selected material. And we can preview that really quickly by stopping the scene and going ahead and just dragging one of these materials, the object at selected material, onto one of the objects in the scene. And that's just kind of a preview of what it's going to look like once we have that red dot intersecting with the game object in the scene. So it's going to look like this. Now, since there's multiple objects in the scene, we're going to need to keep track of which one is selected, and we're going to need to reset its material back to default when it's deselected. So we're going to need one script to manage all of the selections. That is going to be called Selection Manager. So why don't we go ahead and just create that now? I'm going to create the script underneath my scripts folder, and again, I'm going to call it Selection Manager. Now, I want to put this in the scene, so I'm going to go ahead and create a game object, and I'm going to call this game object the Selection Manager as well, and I'm just going to reset its transform. Once that's in the scene, we can drag the Selection Manager onto the object, and we're ready to rock and roll. So why don't we go ahead and open that up in the code editor? We want the selection manager to update its selection each frame. So the first thing we need to do is implement the update method. Next, we're going to want to cast a ray into the scene. So I'll create a new variable called ray, and let's initialize it using the main camera. We'll call screen point to ray, and we're going to pass in the current mouse position. This is because we're using the FPS player controller, so the center of the screen will always correspond to the mouse position. Next, we need to determine whether or not that ray actually collides with any object in the scene. To that end, we're going to use the physics class, and we're going to just check physics.raycast. If raycast returns true, then we'll know that it hit something. Now we need to pass in our ray that we just generated, and we're going to need to pass a reference to a raycast hit object, which I will create now. All right, so if physics.raycast returns true, then that hit object will be populated, and we can use it to grab the transform of the current selection. Perfect. Once we have the selection, we can go ahead and try to grab the selection's renderer. And if it has one, then we'll go ahead and set its material to the highlighted material. Of course, we haven't added the highlight material to our class, so I'm going to go ahead and add it as a Unity serialized field. All right, so we've got enough code here to test, so why don't we just pop back into Unity? Back in Unity, let's select the selection manager. And let's populate the highlight material. I'm going to use the object at selected material that I've created for this project. If you download the project, it would be included with the files. All right, perfect. So let's press play. And now when I look at my objects, they should highlight. Very nice. Uh-oh, except it's not, it's not deselecting, so it's staying highlighted. And on top of that, if I accidentally look at the floor, looks like I'm swimming in a sea of piss. Not good. So we need to do two things. We need to be able to deselect objects and reset their highlight back or rather their material, back to their default material. And we need to be able to differentiate between objects that are selectable, like our gray, dark gray objects, and objects that are not selectable, like the floor. So let's go back into the code editor now. Okay, so let's tackle this one thing at a time. First, I'm going to differentiate between selectable and non-selectable objects using a tag. So I'm going to add a serialized string field called selectable tag. And I'm going to default it to selectable. So any game object that's marked with the selectable tag will be selectable. And in order to do that, we're going to need to add some new logic. So let's go down to our update method. And what I'm going to do is, after we determine the transform, I'm just going to put an if statement that checks the selections tag using compare tag. And I'm going to pass in selectable tag. And we'll wrap the whole thing in brackets. All right, that was easy enough. Next thing we want to do is deselect objects by setting their material back to the default material. So we should really just create another serialized field here, and I'm going to call it default material. And so in order to deselect the current selection, we need to actually keep track of the current selection. So I'm going to add another private field that's going to hold a reference to the current transform that's being selected. All right, so the logic for deselection would look a little something like this. Just the first thing we're going to do in each update is check whether or not the selection field is null or not. And if it's not null, we're going to grab the selection renderer again. Set its material to the default material. And then set selection to null. Now you might be looking at this and you might see this duplication here, and I'm as tempted as you are probably to refactor this, but I'm going to just press on because you never want to refactor too early. Once we finish the main functionality of this class, then I'll go back and we'll refactor this. And we're actually going to see that at the end of the video. But for now, let's just press on. So we have our deselection logic, but we're not actually keeping track of the selection just yet. But that's pretty easy. We can just come down to that if statement that we just added. And at the end, we can go ahead and say selection equal selection. And there we have it. The code isn't pretty, and it actually is error prone. For instance, if that renderer is null when we set the selection, then it's going to fail on deselection. But again, we're going to worry about that sort of stuff later when we refactor. For now, why don't we just pop back into Unity and ensure that the code actually works. Back in Unity, we need to do two things. First, we need to actually create a new tag called selectable. So let's do that now. I'll select add tag, add a new one, call it selectable. Of course, we're going to need to mark our four objects as selectable. Then we need to go to the selection manager and populate that default material. Again, I'm going to use the object at default material that's included with the project if you download it. And now we can go ahead and press play. So if we look at the floor, awesome, we're no longer standing in a pool of piss. And if we look at any one of our objects and look away, we can see that all of our functionality is now in place. We are selecting and deselecting objects as expected. So the code is complete and the logic works, but it's kind of ugly. So the next thing we're going to do is refactor. If you'd like to see that video, then make sure you subscribe and turn on notifications so you'll be notified when it's available. Thank you to all of my patrons, and a special shout out to Dark Rush Photography, NZ, Richard Stance, Sean Carey, Thomas, Wayne Gloss, and Yakov.